I've edited and mixed live broadcast productions for about 15 years now, from concerts by bands of all different genres, live theatre, all the way to massive concerts that have a 100-piece choir, brass band, big bands, kids groups, dancers, all in the one concert, up to 100 tracks for companies like Arts Centre Melbourne, Melbourne Theatre Company and Sydney Opera House. Today I want to show you a quick tip how I use iZotope RX as well as Waves Clarity to clean up my audio in the editing process. Let's get started. The production I've got in front of me was a live concert that we recorded not long ago, here in Melbourne in a cathedral. And it features the Toshi Clinch Big Band, a choir, some singers, and even a tap dancer at one point. I'm pretty sure the arrangements have been redone for the big band, but it's Duke Ellington's Sacred Concerts. And it's quite an eclectic bunch of music, different tracks. Obviously, as I said, it's featuring a big band as well as a choir. But I just want to show you how I used iZotope to clean out a mistake that was made by one of the band members. So have a listen here. So you can hear the baritone actually comes in early. And I'm not sure if he played or he obviously went to hit the note and you could hear it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bypass that group and I can clean that out. But you'll notice because we have so many channels here, let me just set that group up again. We've got lots of channels. You can see it down the side here. So we've got full drums. We've got bass, piano, all this is live, you know, five saxes, three bones, trombones, four trumpets, the choirs, four mics, the vocal mics. We had two sets of room mics. So there's one kind of mid and then further back because it was a massive cathedral. I wanted to get the whole sound. So there's a lot of open mics. So if I just clean that out, you can still hear it. So what I'll show you here. So if we've got this is the room mics. And what I can do is if I send this to iZotope, I can use instant processing and I've got it at replace. And what I can do then, you can see the sound here. Fortunately for me, all that's playing in this one moment is that trumpet. So if I send that back, render it, have a listen here. So if I get rid of it, how good is that? So because it's one long note there, fortunately that was the case, I could clean out that one noise. Now, if you listen to it with everything still on, it's still there. So what we need to do is go through each section. We're going to send it through. So this is the, what was it? Four trumpets, I think. So if I go through here. Oh, sorry, that's a choir mic. So I'll send that back, render that. The trumpet, we won't grab the trumpet, but I'll just undo that group. Let's grab the other trumpets, send that through. Again, you can see it there. Fortunately, the frequency of the notes or the sound doesn't really affect the trumpet. So we'll render that. Let's go the bones next. Now, because we're cleaning this one area, you won't need to add crossfades. You can do it if you want to for the sake of safety that you don't get any clicks, but we shouldn't because the audio technically in between is the exact same. So you can see I've obviously taken out that one bit. What I'm trying to avoid just like fading all them out, if I just fade everything out, you'll lose the live. So all the mics are open at the time. So what we want to avoid is just deleting that section. So see how I've deleted it for, you can see here I've deleted it out of the Barry, but if I did that for literally everything, then the sound of the trumpet coming through all the open mics will sound different. So literally you'll lose the whole live vibe. Let's see if that sounds all right. We might have to do the piano as well. Yeah, it's still there. So yeah, there's the piano. Let's send the piano. Let's just look at that. Clean. Send that back. Render that. We might even check the drum overheads. Yeah, it's in there as well. It's pretty obvious because there's nothing else really going on at that point. Oh, playback's playing up. Don't know why that is. Maybe because I'm doing screen capture at the same time. Have a listen to all of it. All right, what else? Maybe the bass here. So the bass has got a mic and a DI. So the DI is obviously going to be clean, but we need to take it out of the bass. Literally, we're going through every channel of audio or any mic that's open, which is pretty much all of them. Let's see how that sounds. Look at that. Perfect. I'm going to undo all of these just so you can hear it again. I know it's annoying because I did all that hard work. Oh, don't want to do that one. Gonna redo it again. Pretty awesome, hey? So that's using iZotope RX, and I just turned on instant processing, which you can press I, and then I'm just going to replace, and you're just replacing. Fortunately, this example was pretty straightforward, but don't forget that you have these tools. Sometimes you might not have as many mics open, but because I wanted to keep that live vibe, I wanted to, you know, keep all those mics open, and replace is great. Replace will work. Obviously, there's just the trumpet, and it's you can see the frequencies, but replace is quite good at filling gaps. So if you need to like extend a crash cymbal to fix an edit, you tend to be able to use replace, and it will make the crash cymbal go longer. You could get rid of other hits and stuff. I've used that before. Now I just want to show you. So there's, I'll find the section that's got a bit of choir singing. We had about 20 people in a choir who were singing right behind the brass band. We had four mics on them spread across evenly, but they were right behind the trumpets who were blasting. There's also the drum kit that wasn't far away. And there's a lot of cymbal bleed coming through the choir mics. So I thought clarity, because it's made for dialogue, but also the voice, that I thought it could clear out some of the voice. So I'm going to show you now what it sounds like with clarity. Here's a version of the plugin. So I'm using about 32% here. And you see I've notched it out a little bit in the kind of vocal range. But of course, like we want it to be taking as much of the cymbals and the low end rumble. But I'm going to play it for you and then bypass each of them as I go along.
Genesis. Exodus. Leviticus. Numbers.
That's some serious cymbal coming through.
Joshua. Judges. Ruth. Samuel. Samuel. Kings. Kings. Chronicles. Chronicles. Ezra.
I could probably take it further, but I don't want to lose the clarity in the voice. Particularly later on when it's just the choir singing, well, you know, we might bypass it at that point. But to take away, you know, that's a good few dB, if not more, of cymbal sizzle and stuff. And it means we keep the clarity of the voice. We don't lose any of the top end by just doing, say, an EQ roll-off to get rid of those cymbals. We actually just use clarity. It means we keep the clarity of the singing, but we obviously lose those cymbals. There's some quick tips on how you can use RX and Clarity to clean up your audio in your live productions. If you've got any questions, please ask in the comments below. If I find some other good examples in this production, I'll make sure that I share them. So you better subscribe and hit that bell icon so you get notified of future videos. And I'll see you on the next one.